This is Legends from the Pacific, bonus episode number one. Are electric fans fatal while you sleep? I am Kamuela Kaneshiro. While most of us may know the old saying that washing your hair, then going to sleep with an open window may cause you to get sick, parts of Asia have a deadlier belief that applies to portable electric fans and ceiling fans. You see, it is believed a fan may suffocate you from its constant breeze or circulate your carbon dioxide back to you. The following is a Legends from the Pacific original story and is based on cultural records. She returned home from a challenging day, and the summer heat wave didn't help. She welcomed the cool air conditioning in her cramped apartment, needed a shower, her comfortable bed, and an escape from her grueling day. While others relaxed with light-hearted sitcoms or scrolling through social media, her escape were dark and twisted stories. Tonight's macabre options swirled in her mind as the shower cleansed her body. Beside her bed, her cramped apartment seemed hotter. The cool air was no longer flowing from the ceiling vent. She cursed herself for forgetting the air conditioning was going to be shut off for maintenance. She turned on the ceiling fan. A hum stirred it to life. Faint dust glided from the rotating blades. Her mother's warning of sleeping with a fan on echoed in her mind. At the bedroom window, she admired the city lights that overpowered the stars, then cracked the window open. Sticky heat rushed in, devouring the remnants of her room's cool air. She shut the window, hoped the remnants of cool air would sustain her till the air conditioning was restored, and got into bed. She snatched her mobile phone and selected a morbid story about parallel dimensions, then watched the twirling blades pressing the remaining cool air upon her. Her phone's low battery made her scowl. She began reading, hoping to be asleep before her device died. The grotesque story prickled her skin. She welcomed the chills running across her flesh. The story's ghastly images followed her to sleep. They danced in her head and tormented her dreams. Soon, she did not feel like herself. The specters choked her. She tried waking up, but couldn't, and struggled freeing herself from the phantasms. She sat up in bed. Her bedroom was dark. The cityscape beyond her window was pitch black. The ceiling fan was motionless. Her room was as silent as a tomb. She grabbed her mobile phone. Its screen remained black. She connected her charger, but the phone remained dead. Tonight's story of slipping into another dimension swirled in her mind as she scanned the lifeless city. She gasped, "Could the stories about fans be true?" Dread filled her as she expected seeing her motionless body laying under her sheets. Her bed was empty. A bang echoed in the night. Cold air fell upon her from the ceiling vent, and the cityscape illuminated as electricity was restored from a power outage. Today, people still believe fans are fatal. Because of this, some fans have a timer to shut off the fan. Where did this belief begin? In the past, places throughout Asia had sketchy power grids, which couldn't sustain fans being on throughout sweltering nights. So, the cities restricted keeping fans on while people slept. The populace provided the rest. I apologize for not producing newer episodes. I had things ready to go. However, I lost a couple friends over the past weeks. One's passing was a bit peculiar, then the other passed the following week. Unusual things keep occurring, and my paranormal investigations continue. Rest assured, I shall do my best to not only get back to our weekly episodes, but make up for our missing episodes. More about this on future episodes. As stated earlier, this is considered a bonus episode because it was more of a superstition or belief that was not connected to gods, creatures, or spirits that's usually shared on our show. So, this bonus episode will not count towards one of your missing episodes. I just felt this was an intriguing belief that I could make a decent story out of. But let me know if you liked it, and I may make more of these types of bonus episodes. As always, thank you very much for your continued support. Thank you for listening. Mahalo and a hui ho.